Hey, what's going on, everyone? This is TW Fungi at Mark's Daily Apple doing my countdown warning clock video log entry for 26 September 2010. A few days ago, I had made a recipe here at home and it got a great response from a lot of you, and some have already tried doing it, and then others sent personal messages, emails, and posted up on my journal that they wanted to know exactly how I made my quote-unquote chicken horns. So, if you take a look here, I'll show you quickly how to do this. It doesn't take much time. I've got a piece of bacon here. I usually use a medium thick bacon, as you can see. It's not real thick, but it's definitely not thin. A good medium thick bacon will be good. I have a drumstick here for spices. I have marjoram, salt, pepper, oregano, and I have a piece of aluminum foil. That's pretty much all you're going to need to make these, but you first got to start by prepping your drumstick, and the first thing to do is to remove the skin. You can save the skin for later for make cracklings or something, but for this specific recipe we need to remove the skin. So a lot of times all you can do is pull on it, and then you use a paring knife. What I do is I find the bone and I pierce just beyond the bone, being very careful. It usually helps to use a sharp knife. And then all I do is go around, cut the tendons and the meat all the way around the bone, being careful not to cut myself. And basically you want to free the meat just like that. Okay. Now, sometimes you can just pull, if you're lucky, and pull the skin completely off. I'm probably not going to be that lucky this evening, other than a small piece, which is okay. Also, I don't know if you can see it here, but there's a knuckle. There's another piece of bone here, and here at the knuckle, you'll see a little bit of a pocket. Carefully insert your knife in there and kind of wiggle it back and forth, being careful not to stab yourself, and go all the way around. Sometimes you have to get it from a couple different angles. And there you go. It doesn't have to be perfect, but with a little bit of patience, you can go ahead and remove it. Again, it's not going to look super pretty, but it's definitely going to be better than not doing it. Then, what you do is you carefully, not too hard, you start to pull the meat down and form a ball. Now, one thing you'll notice at times, there might be a small piece of bone, sharp bone, and it's almost like a type of bone like you'd find for salmon. So be careful with that and remove it with your knife. All you do is you just keep clearing the meat down until it forms a ball as such. Okay, now this is where I usually will take a little bit of salt, not much, just enough to coat, some pepper, then I take the marjoram, make sure to coat it nice and good, just a little bit extra, and what's great about these is you can roll them in the seasoning that you just laid out. Lo and behold, you have a seasoned bird. Now, I'm going to wipe my hands. Next thing I do is I go ahead and grab the drumstick, and then I grab my bacon. Now, usually it's best if you let the bacon be at room temperature. You find a spot on the top of the meat, holding your thumb. A little tricky, but what you want to do is you want to stretch without breaking the bacon. You want to pull and slightly stretch all the way around, and then pack it in tight with your hand as such. Okay? Then I take some of the oregano and coat all the sides, all the edges. Again, using it to pick up my leftover seasoning. And again, packing it in tight as such, like that. Okay? So then All you do is you pop it in an oven at 350 degrees until the bacon is done. Once the bacon is done on the outside where it gets that dark caramelized color, the chicken inside will be cooked perfectly. Now, just a few minutes ago, before starting the video, I pulled these puppies out. All I did is lay them on. I take a little bit of aluminum foil. This is before you put it in the oven. And what this does is it helps protect the bone from charring too much or drying out and splintering. So you put it just like this on a cookie sheet with a cooling rack. You set it on top, and they'll come out looking like this. And so here's a finished one. And what I'll do is when I go to serve and do the presentation, I pull off the aluminum foil. And there you have one of the done drumsticks. Next thing I do is I'll make some of Mark's homemade ketchup. I will add a mustard of my choice. I'll add a little bit of mayonnaise and some fresh prepared horseradish. Mix them up really, really well. And what this does is it gives it a sweet, real wonderful sweet and kick to it. And all you do is dip in just a little bit. Oh wow. You can see the drumstick, I mean the meat inside is so tender and moist. It's not dried out, and that's a wonderful thing about wrapping this meat or any kind of meat in bacon, is because it protects the meat inside, keeps it moist, keeps it tender, gives it a wonderful flavor. And that's pretty much it. It took in a 350 degree oven, it takes roughly anywhere between, I'd say, a comfortable 15 minutes on up to an hour and 10 minutes. It just depends on where you're at in the world. And you just cook it until the bacon is really done and wonderfully dark on the outside. Then you know your chicken on the inside is done perfect. So, with that being said, hope you guys enjoy. If you have any questions, just go ahead and let me know. And I look forward to seeing you at the next one. Take care, guys. Bye.